Look at the little sirens. Look at the little flower petals on the that. Hey, it's been a while. I know. I've been going through some shit. I can't seem to get my shit together 100%. But that's not really here nor there. The thing is, it is the 19th day of April. And I believe this is episode 28A of my show Drive Time. So I want to thank you for joining me. I got a banana in my lap. And that's not a euphemism. Here, it's orange. It's a yellow. Yellow. They're yellow bananas. I just almost called it an orange banana. Ah, well, so this morning unfolded... if you like cable news, this is pretty much, you know, your kind of best day ever, because, there's, the Boston Marathon bombing, suspects have been, one of them's dead, one of them's on the loose, the entire Boston area in a town called Watertown, Massachusetts, outside of Boston, is like on a complete lockdown. Manhunt. Media's going crazy. They might have bombs. They were throwing bombs out of the window of a car. Just there's too many facts. So trying to process all these facts is impossible. But then again, there's just also this insatiable urge to want to know. You got to know. You at least have to know something. I feel it deeply. I mean, not as deeply as some people. I got to go to work. I'm driving to work. It's 8:59 a.m. Eastern Standard. On a overcast day, there's a lady with a American flag bandana, and she's doing a dance right now with her headphones on and singing. She's doing like a workout maneuver. She's just living life to the fullest. And that was great. And she's still just boogieing like a fucking crazy person. I was gonna take a camera for her. She probably would have liked it, but I didn't want to exploit it. That was my moment I just had with her as I was trying to talk about the absolute evils in the world. There's this lady with an American flag bandana on. She was a probably a 50-year-old African American lady. Not that that matters, but just kind of give you a visual. With a pink sweatshirt tied around her waist, and she was just living it up. Living it up. And that makes me feel good. And I'm gonna be alright. I got a busy day at work today. I got a lot of shit I gotta get done. This person in front of me is so lost, they're about to stop. They keep almost stopping. I'm trying not to get mad because, you know what, life's too short for me to get mad at like somebody. Like, now he's going in a one-way street. I mean, just, you know, sometimes you just gotta drive. You'll find where you're going. You know, somebody had to turn around. But, you know. I mean, just, it's fine. If everything's fine, that's what I'm saying. She's going to school. So, I don't know. If she's got a kid there, you know, who knows. It's, really that impulse of life is just to, you know, run away from the anxious feelings and the darkness and the hatred. And the unpleasant feelings and just the feelings of depression, and that there's like an evil, an overwhelming evil, whether it be in society or be like in yourselves that you can't get rid of and that's somehow controlling you. And that exists, and that's real. But what life is a struggle to move towards that or move away from that. And if you peel it back on every situation, take moment by moment, You can pretty much peel away any moment and find something good. Find something, I don't want to say artistic, or some sort of artistic beauty, even in the worst situations. And I'm like a fucking, you know, who am I? I'm some idiot. I'm just dealing with this shit like everyone else. And I thought today I was going to start rebooting this for at least for a little while. I don't know how long I'm going to continue to do this. I might stop for a while and then start it up again. Something like that. But this is, anyway, still continuation. I took about a week off from doing these videos. And I just wanted to come back and talk again because, you know. He just flew out in front of me and basically, I let him go though, and I gave him a thumbs up, a kind of a sarcastic thumbs up, Because he flew out of stop sign, he basically was making a left, and he flew almost right in front of me. It's just like, he's driving a BMW with tinted windows and Florida license plates. You know, and like, I just judged that man in that car completely to the point where that guy's a dick, I don't like him. He's a fucking dick. And you know what? He's been in a rush just now, and he seems to fit the profile of a dick. With the whole the Beamer tinted windows, driving like an asshole, Florida plates up in this luxurious New Jersey hill land. But maybe he's not. Maybe if I met that guy in a bar, I wouldn't know from Adam, what his background was or what kind of car he drove. It doesn't matter. You know. Be cool, man. Just be fucking cool. This bomber, 19 years old, one of the bombers. This guy's one of the guys who's still alive as of this moment. I doubt he's gonna make it out of this scenario alive. Hopefully he doesn't kill anybody else before he goes, because this is just tragic. My worst case scenario right now, and I don't know any facts at all, I'm just fucking talking, but is that he's holed up in somebody's house because he was on the run, and I believe he got on feet traffic, and they got lost in the early twilight, or you know, early, kind of still dark outside morning. It was that early. And he escaped and he's holed up in somebody's house. That's, I think, what they're dealing with right now. But he's 19 years old, man. He's fucking 19 years old. I'm 31, almost 32, and I'm a fucking idiot. I don't know shit about the world. I don't know shit enough about the world to say that it'd be better off and that I'd be doing some sort of justice to it by committing acts of mass murder and fear and terror. The fact that someone can make a decision like that is, you know, that's the thing I'm talking about. Not even the carnage, it's that choice, which is the most, the thing I'm most scared of. I'm not going to live in fear or panic, but I do live in fear and panic of that disease, that moment where a person, a 19-year-old person, feels like he's ready to make that choice. Wow. Anyway, be safe out there, kids. I'm gonna wrap it up for this episode. We'll be back today, though. We'll be back with a couple more. I think I'm gonna keep doing this for a little while. I got something to say. I got some stuff on my mind. I'm trying to reboot some things, some projects. I'm trying to tie up the loose ends. Trying to get to a place where not I can't tie up the loose ends, but I can see how potentially they all might be tied up. Right? That's the place I'm struggling to get to as I shudder. Yeah, away from the dark spots. Not shudder. I turn boldly away from them with my double middle fingers blaring behind my back style. So I'm like, you know, like kind of put my hands in a weird angle behind my back, double finger back at them, and then move like a peacock away.